Good morning, Muttonistas. It is match day again. I'm in Bristol at Temple Mead Station, but today's match and today's vlog has got nothing at all to do with Bristol, just happens to be where I'm starting my journey off from. So, we're going to take a train to London for today's match and vlog of Crystal Palace against Manchester City, and three vital points are needed to close the gap on Arsenal in the quest for the 2022-23 Premier League title. Ask what I'm doing in Bristol, because our match here was about 10 days ago. It's a long story that I'm not going to bother telling you, but I quite like this city, so I thought I'd pop back and see a few friends. Anyway, let's head off down to London. Well, I think across to London's more accurate from here. Okay, Muttonistas, I've arrived in London. For those of you who don't live in the UK, the trains that come from the west of the country to London, they finish at Paddington Station. Now, to get to Crystal Palace's ground, I have a choice of Victoria Station or London Bridge Station, then three stations which are kind of equidistant to the ground. I'm going to go first to London Bridge Station and then to a station called Thornton Heath. There's a good reason for that. First of all, there's a great place for food near London Bridge Station, as you'll see shortly, and the best away pub is near Thornton Heath. So let's go and hit the tube and find a bit of food. Okay, Muttonistas, a Cockney odyssey to the south of London would not be complete without a trip to the famous Borough Market behind me. So, Muttonistas, I was actually quite lucky to get a seat here. I'm not sure I have enough hands to carry a glass and a plate of seafood or meat or whatever I'm going to have, but fortunately I've been able to sit at a counter. Now, the stall is quite Spanish. Although I bring you a lot of content from Spain, well, it was a case of any port in a storm. I'll try and find another place for something else and a glass of red later, but for the time being, we're on the carver. Come on, City. Okay, first dish arrived, the mixed fried seafood, an Andalusian favourite, had it many times in Malaga myself, served with an aioli, thank you, and of course a quick slurp. And the second dish has arrived, calçots with romesco sauce. Calçots are a type of spring onion. Here they're fried tempura style in batter. And for those of you who don't know, romesco sauce is actually a sauce made of tomatoes, garlic, hazelnuts and almonds. And I love it. Anyway, enough waffle, down to the food. So in the mixed seafood, it's mainly squid and fried white bait or boccaronis. I'm not quite sure which. I'd strongly recommend this dish if you're here. It's done very, very nicely. Seafood fresh and tasty, and the carve is lovely as well. But have a quick slurp to cleanse the palate before we go on to these spring onions. But I think I'd better get another glass, don't you, Muttonistas? Again, beautifully done, just as I'd have them in Spain. And these calçots are not just any spring onions. I'm not quite sure why they're different, but they are different. They're tastier and they're very, very seasonal, and they're usually served in the spring. And it is so easy to get the batter wrong, particularly when frying up tempura stuff. This is right on the money. Anyway, the reinforcements have arrived. It's difficult for me to eat this one-handed, so I'm going to put the camera down and I'll be back with you in a bit. Anyway, Muttonistas, I have picked those plates clean, so tasty it was. And I do love this concept of eating in markets, especially sitting around at a stall eating market fresh food. Absolutely fantastic. Sometimes a bit more expensive than a regular restaurant, but for atmosphere and taste and quality, it's fantastic. Okay, not always for price. Just a little bit of carver left to wet my whistle. So I'll see if I can squeeze something else in, if it's small. I'll try and look for something at another stall. I might not have anything else because that was pretty filling and satisfying. But regardless, one thing is for sure, folks, I am match fit today. That came to £31 after service. I'm not sure they should charge service when you're being served at the counter, but anyway, it is what it is. Reasonable for this part of London, I'd say, and good quality. The fish, as I suspected, was white bait, and the stall, Brindisa, they actually have a sit-in tapas bar just set off the market. I think they have another one or maybe two elsewhere in London. Anyway, recommend that place if you're here. Well, folks, I did say I'll have something else if I spotted something I fancied. Now, just across the way, they had stuffed sea urchins and oysters. Queue way too big here, but there is another oyster stall here, and they've been flying out of the counter, so I suspect they're pretty fresh. So for dessert, Muttonistas, I'm going to have a few oysters. Right, dessert has arrived. Half a dozen oysters. Now, the only problem is I haven't actually got anywhere to sit or stand to eat those, and I really need to take something like a glass of champagne or white wine to accompany these, but I'll try and find somewhere. Okay, Muttonistas, found my glass of champagne. The problem is it's very difficult to find somewhere to stand or sit, put your stuff down on a table. So I've had to improvise here, and some of you might find this a bit gruesome. I've had to rest them on the side of a bin. Anyway, these are Dorset rock oysters. The guy at the stall said they got them in yesterday, said they're really beautiful. So I didn't bother with any fancy sauces, just a squeeze of lemon. And right he is too. Nicely shucked as well, which is quite a skill, I can assure you. Anyway, this is so difficult to perch the glass of champagne and the oysters on the top of a bin, so I'm going to get on with it again without a camera, and I'll be back. This time we'll be talking football, possibly with some beer.
The Southern Service team, Epsom, calling
Okay, Muttonistas, I didn't actually go to the designated away pub, which meant I would have had to gone to Thornton Bridge. I went to Norwood Junction because there were delays on the line to Thornton Bridge, so I got off at one of the other two stations close to the ground. And I've come to a pub called the Shelverdine Goathouse, and one thing that's good here is that they have proper cask ale. Pretty decent pale ale, if you ask me. And some of the pubs around the station were kind of lager only, so it was a lucky find. Don't know if this is home only, but I just marched in confidently. I'm not wearing colours and I'm not a troublemaker anyway. City are playing Edison at the back, Ake at left back again, who's been playing well. Johnny Stones makes a welcome return at right back, and Akanji and Diaz make up the back four in the middle. In midfield, we have Rodri and Gundogan, and further ahead, Grealish, Bernardo and Foden, and Erling Haaland up top, but no Kevin De Bruyne. Is that a representation of his form, or is he being saved for the Champions League game on Tuesday? Possibly the same could be said for Kyle Walker. Now, as for Palace, obviously their danger man is Wilfred Zaha. I really rate that player quite highly, and let's hope we keep him quiet today. They are on a bad run of form, it has to be said, and haven't actually won a game since the turn of the calendar year. But these games are always, always tricky. Their crowd will be up for it, their players really should be up for it. And any Premier League game, I mean, just look at Liverpool earlier today, losing 1-0 at the bottom side Bournemouth after a 7-0 win against Manchester United. They're never easy. They never are. Having said that, City's away form has picked up after a pretty spotty start to the calendar year, so I'm full of optimism for this game, and I'm going to go for 3-1 to City. Well, I'm in a pretty weird part of the Arthur Waite stand here at Palace, as you can see behind me. Stewards, concretes and gangways. And for the second season running, I can't see the left-hand corner flag at the other end. This ground really does need a bit of improvement. In City have had a few good chances already and we've not put any of them in. Let's not do another Forest here. And we've given away possession a couple of times on the halfway line, which has allowed Palace to spring some promising counter-attacks. In control, but I think we should have been ahead by now. Well, half-time, Palace 0, City 0, and disturbing echoes and memories of our 0-0 draw here last season. Good chances missed, Palace looking pretty impotent up front, but we can't take them. Come on, we've got to stick them away. One crumb of comfort, though, is that any City goal scored will be at the half where I'm standing, which means you'll get a better view as well, folks. Well, I managed to get a half-time beer. I wondered why that was possible, but when I looked at the bottle and saw it was 3.8% Carlsberg, I kind of wondered why. Not sure I'm going to drink much or all of this anyway. In, tons and tons of pressure on that Palace goal, who still can't put it in the back of the net. We really need to win this one. Minutes left. The City have won a penalty. Come on, Haaland, don't miss this one for Christ's sake. Injury time left. We have to be careful, especially not to concede a set piece deep in our half. I remember they got an equaliser from a last minute free kick against United, I think about a month ago, so just be careful here, City, no mistakes. Again, Mutton Easters. Well, what about that? That was a bit sweaty, that was. Unfortunately, to be able to get my train, I had to go straight to the station, straight onto the tube, straight through Paddington onto the train, so no chance for a post-match pint. Well, I will have some beer with some friends once I get back to Bristol. Anyway, so I'm going to have to review the match with you without a drink. I know that's not good form, folks. And I have to say, obviously, it wasn't the greatest of games, but City easily had enough chances to put that game to bed earlier. I was a bit disappointed with some of the finishing. It's been a recurrent problem this season after the initial flurry of goals in the first dozen matches. Both Haaland and Alvarez guilty of missing these chances. The defence, well, the defenders did okay. Palace did very little, just that as they shot when they were already one down. They're stuck in a bit of a rut at the moment. The odd draw and no wins since the new year started. And they could get sucked into a relegation battle, but I think they've probably just about got enough points on the board to eventually be okay. Their defence did hold firm for a long, long time. I was starting to think it wasn't going to come, and then I was going to have to endure my third consecutive 0-0 away at Palace. But finally a mistake from Elise. It was a clear penalty on Gundogan, and now, thank goodness, we've got somebody who sticks the penalties away. If you look at City from last year, the year before that, an incredible number of penalty kicks were missed. So, a messy game, a scrappy 3 points, but just what we need. It's over to Arsenal tomorrow, who have a tricky tie at Fulham. Not the most difficult, but still fairly difficult. We put the pressure back on them, which sometimes we've failed to do lately. And I think they might crumble eventually, whether it's tomorrow or in a later game in the season, because this luck in getting these last-minute winners off the keeper's back, or with the very last kick, that can't go on forever. Anyway, Muttonistas, that does just about wrap things up for this vlog. And I didn't tell a lie because I didn't realise a cart with refreshments was coming round. And I've managed to get myself a St. Austell Cornish Pale Ale. Just the ticket it is as well. Anyway, I'm going to love you and leave you. Please remember, keep liking, keep sharing, keep subscribing. Please tell your friends about me. But most of all, don't forget, you can't beat a bit of mutton.